Hey everybody, today I'm coming to you from my back patio here, and I decided it was time to do something a little bit different. It's been a while since I did any sort of weightlifting or weight training video, and I thought it was a good time to do it. Reason being, I actually just started lifting seriously again a couple weeks ago. I've actually got my son Jordan lifting with me now, so it's pretty fun, and I just want to see you know, how strong I can get again at my age. Actually last night we were working out, and I pulled out this old piece of equipment that I had made a few years back, and I thought you might find it interesting. So that's the main reason I wanted to make the video and just give you a look at it, and maybe talk to you a little bit about the sort of training I do. This first thing here, as you can see, is about as rudimentary as it gets, and you've probably seen this in a previous video if you've watched any of my poor man's home gym videos. And it's not really the reason I'm making the video, that's for this other thing over here, but I'll get to that in just a minute. This first device is just obviously a piece of pipe going through a couple cement blocks. The block over there, it's marked, it weighs 46.5 pounds. This block weighs about 44 pounds, okay? The whole assembly there together, the basic weight is 108 pounds, all right? Now, that's not much weight, obviously, but that's what I leave it at to get started. And then what I do is I take these 25 pound, 27 pound plates, and with the ropes on them, I slip them over the ends to make it heavier as I go. And that's how I train with it. Now, the reason this is kind of useful as far as training is that that pipe is actually 2 3/8 inches in diameter. So, you know, more than double the thickness, or roughly double the thickness of a typical barbell. I think they're 1 1/4 inches or something like that. And that's what makes it difficult. If you get into grip training, you start reading about the old strongman, that sort of thing, you'll no doubt come across Thomas Inch. He was famous for lifting this very heavy dumbbell. I think it was like only like 165 or 168 pounds, but it had a big thick handle on it, which made it very, you know, hard to manage and difficult to lift. And also the fact that he weighed less than the dumbbell, I believe, which is what made it really impressive. But later people upped the ante and they came up with the Millennium dumbbell, which it's been a while since I was into this, but it weighs somewhere around 225, 227 pounds, something like that. But again, with a big fat handle. And those are the sort of things I was training to do, and that's why I came up with this originally. Now, when I trained with this all the time for a month or two, I got up to where I was lifting 245 pounds on that 2 3/8 inch diameter bar, and I was pretty happy with that, you know, with one hand, obviously. And so I was developing pretty good grip strength from it. Now, and I'm not implying that that means I can lift the Millennium dumbbell or anything, because honestly, this is longer, so it's a totally different feel than the short dumbbell and everything, so don't get me wrong, but that's what I use to train, and I'll show you that in just a minute, how I use it. But the main reason for this video, before I rattle on too much, is this thing. This is a little device, obviously very simply made, that I made a few years ago, and this makes lifting stuff one-handed much more difficult. And all it is I took a big turnbuckle. So you got an eyelet on either side, the same as the turnbuckles you'd see like on the corner of a boxing ring, that sort of thing. And but what I did, I greased it up with some moly grease. I stuck it into a piece of pipe, and all, you know, it's all greased up in there. Then I put that piece of pipe inside of another one and greased it up as well in between. And the reason I did that is because now, and then the other part of this, I should probably show you real quickly, is I have this little plate here. Let me tip this up. You can see this is just a little plate with some little kind of feed on it, and then there's this heavy rod that goes up through the center, and then it has a let me turn it here, it has a hook on it that you can hook, you know, your different devices onto and then lift, and obviously you can stack quite a bit of weight on it. These are 27 pound plates. These are actually made from their pipe, gas pipeline caps, and they just have been torched open to make weight plates, and they turn out to weigh about 27 pounds a piece. But as you can see with the big opening, it goes over the hook good, and I can stack them up and you can get some pretty serious weight on here. And the way this works is you just obviously put that hook in there like that, and then you lift up on it. Now you think, well, why is that so difficult? The big difference between this and that stationary bar is that you can kind of like hook your hand under that one and it doesn't roll on you. This one, when you start to lift, it pivots because it can spin between these two pieces of pipe and between that pipe and the turnbuckle. So there's all sorts of movement. And what it does, as soon as you start to lift, it kind of rolls to the opening in your hand like that. So you actually have to have very strong fingers to hold on to that and lift with it. And I'll actually set the camera up on the tripod, and I'll just lift a few with you, just so you can see how these work. Now this first one, like I said, it's really just a matter of getting a good balance point on it, and then getting a good solid grip. And it's really, with 180 pounds, it's really not that hard. Just about anybody could do that. You just lift it up, and that's all I did. I would go like that, and then I would switch hands and go like that. And then, you know, obviously you just keep adding weight. It's just really simple. I just slip the, and I don't even worry about like if the rope's like exactly equal or if it's hanging on exactly equal, because part of that is you're just gonna have to adjust when you start to lift it, okay? So with 225, this would be 158 pounds. You just gotta find that balance point, like I said. And, you know, try to lift smart, you know, bend your legs. Because it's all about the grip strength, not so much about lifting it with your back. And you see I got a little like off kilter there because I didn't have the balance point quite right. But, and then that's what I did basically. Let me move this one out of the way. But anyway, that's how I trained with that cement block device. I just kept hanging more and more plates off the end of those pipes until it got more and more difficult. And like I said, I worked up to 245 on that. I'm sure I could do more if I keep with it. So I'm gonna start training with it again and just see how far I can go with it. I don't have particularly large, you know, fingers or forearms. I'm actually pretty skinny arm in the forearms. So I was pretty happy that I was able to even do what I did. But this device is much more difficult to use, and I'll just show you it real quickly. Right now, to give you an idea, that was 158 pounds, okay, and that came up really easily, you can see. But this is just 327s plus the plate, so it's 81 plus the weight of this, so it's somewhere around 92 pounds is all this is, okay. So that's like 60 pounds less than that, but I gotta tell you, the effort required to lift this with this rolling handle is about equal or worse. I'm sure it's worse, actually. But you just hook this in there like that. You just grip it right here in the center and just try to get yourself over the top of it so you don't pull your back or anything, and then just lift up. Now, I mean, that's not like incredibly difficult, but I would say it's on par with the difficulty of what I just lifted there, despite being 60 pounds lighter. So, and let me assure you, it wouldn't take very much more than this to actually max out my grip on this particular device, because it really is that difficult. In fact, I'll throw another 27 on here, which would bring it to 119 pounds, which obviously is not that much weight. I mean, like I said, that's 158. So we're talking 40, almost, you know, 40 pounds less, 39 pounds less than that. And I'll be lucky if I can even lift it, to be honest with you. Oh man, I can almost get it up. Oh, see? No joke. Now, part of that, obviously, I'm pretty weak right now because I haven't lifted in quite a while. But that illustrates the difficulty of using this rolling handle, because I could easily do over 200 pounds on that right now, even without training, because it's a solid bar and I can kind of hook my hand under it, get my wrist hooked, and then lift up with some power. This thing doesn't allow you to put any kind of hook in your wrist to make it easier or anything like that. So that's how difficult it makes it. And I don't mind showing you that. I mean, you can see that's not that much weight, and it made me fail to lift it. I could actually feel the joints in my hands kind of popping and stuff because I was squeezing it so hard trying to get it up, but I couldn't. And that's why that is a good training device. One more thing, guys. I just thought of a way to sort of illustrate that it is the handle that's making it that difficult to lift, and not just some lack of strength on my part. If you'll notice, this is the same weight that I was just failing to lift with that handle. And with this skinny little pipe, and my hands are even sweaty, I'll just show you, I can actually grip this and just lift it up without any trouble. So as you can see, it's not really a lack of strength in my hand per se, you know, if I was lifting on some other device. It's the fact that this rolls the way it does, and the fact that the handle's so thick, that really does make it that difficult. So, I mean, it's not something you'd want to get out of the gym to impress people with how strong you are, because obviously you're not going to be able to lift nearly as much weight with this thing on there. But if your real goal is to make your hands and your forearms as strong as they could possibly be, it definitely is good for that. And then when you go back to lifting a regular barbell or dumbbell, it'll come off the floor like nothing. And if you're into stuff like arm wrestling, where it requires really good, strong wrists and hands, that's the perfect device to train with. So maybe you can make some variation of that on your own, because I can vouch for the fact that it works really well. But anyway, guys, I just kind of wanted to share these with you. And obviously, I'm not up to my full strength at all right now. But as I lift and get a little more involved in this again, I'll probably come back and make a few more videos about training and that sort of thing. Anyway, hopefully you found this interesting. I appreciate you watching and commenting, and I'll see you later. Bye.